Hello friends, today we are going to see what could be the output of a system, or we can say that what could be the impulse response of a system whose transfer function, or we can say the difference equation, is given as y of n plus 3 y of n minus 1 plus 2 y of n minus 2 equals to 2x of n minus x of n minus 1. So this is my difference equation given, and to the problem asked to me is determine the impulse response. So I need to determine the impulse response of this system. So we know that whenever we say impulse response, x of n is equal to delta n and y of n equals to h of n, right? So my z transform on the above equation will lead to x of z. Z transform of an impulse is 1, and y of n will give me y of z, and h of n will give me h of z. So what I'll do is I will write wherever I find y of n, I will have to replace it by h of z now, and whenever I have x, I will replace everything by 1. So let us first replace once and then apply z transform, but this was just an intermediate stage. Let us say step 1, replace, okay, x of n by delta n and y of n by h of n. So whenever I get a problem to determine the impulse response, the first step that I will do by default is replace my x of n by delta n's and my y of n by h of n's. Then my equation becomes h of n plus 3 h of n minus 1 plus 2 h of n minus 2 equals to 2. Now here that is delta n minus delta n minus 1, right? Now step 2 is to apply z transform. Okay, I will apply z transform to this equation. Let us give this equation number 2. So I apply z transform to equation number 2. So when I apply z transform to equation number 2, I get h of z, because h of n will be replaced by h of z, plus 3 h of n minus 1 multiply by z inverse and h of z, plus 2 h of n minus 2 z raised to minus 2 into h of z equals to 2 delta n, z transform is 1 minus, okay, now I have delta n minus 1 which will give me z inverse and again into 1. So I have 2 minus z inverse on the x side, and h of z plus 3 z inverse h of z plus 2 z raised to minus 2 h of z on the right hand, left hand side of the equation. Now I pull out h of z common and I get 1 plus 3 z inverse plus 2 z raised to minus 2 equals to 2 minus z inverse. Now we get h of z equals to 2 minus z inverse upon 1 plus 3 z inverse plus 2 z raised to minus 2. Now we have all in terms of z raised to negative powers, make them positive power. To make them positive power, I will multiply and divide by z square. In the numerator and the denominator, I will get 2 z square minus z divided by z square plus 3z plus 2. That is, I'll get z into, I'll pull out z common, I'll get 2z minus 1 divided by the roots in the denominator will be z plus 1 into z plus 2. Okay, So my transfer function now is this z into 2z minus 1 upon z plus 1 and z plus 2. Now that is not done yet. Let us go to step number 3. We have seen step number 2 as to apply the z transform on the difference equation and get h of z. Once we get h of z, now what is step 3? Step 3 is to obtain the impulse response h of n. So I wanted to finally obtain the impulse response h of n by h of z. So I will write my h of z again. This is z into 2z minus 1 divided by z plus 1 into z plus 2. Okay. Now, whenever I get such kind of an equation and I am asked to find h of n, then you have to use, now this is step 3 may A. So we have a sub step in step 3, that is A step. We have to apply partial fraction expansion to the above equation. So I will apply partial fraction expansion to this equation and it will lead me to h of z by z. Now why I did this step as h of z by z? Because if the degree of the numerator and the denominator polynomial is equal, then we cannot apply a partial fraction expansion. Partial fraction expansion demands that the numerator degree should be less than the denominator's degree. So to make the denominator degree more than the numerator's degree, I have divided h of z by z. So I get h of z by z, and here I will get 2z minus 1 upon z plus 1 into z plus 2. Okay, that now I have to solve that a upon z plus 1 plus b upon z plus 2, which is h of z by z. Now let us take and find the constant a and b. So a is equal to, it is z plus 1 into h of z by z at z equals to minus 1. So that is equal to z plus 1. H of z by z is nothing but 2z minus 1 divided by z plus 1 into z plus 2, and at z equals to minus 1 I have to put. So z plus 1 will get cancelled, and you put the value of z as minus 1 over here, it will give minus 2 minus 1 divided by, here if I put minus 1 that will give minus 1 plus 2, so this will give minus 1 plus 2, so that will give me minus 3 by minus 1 plus 2 will give me 1. So the answer is minus 3. So now my a is equal to minus 3. Okay. So my a is equal to minus 3. Now I have to go for b value. So for the b value, I'll go b equals to z plus 2 into h of z by z at z equals to minus 2. So I will have z plus 2, h of z is 2z plus 1 divided by z plus 1 into z plus 2. That will lead to z plus 2 gets cancelled, and I have 2z minus 1 divided by z plus 1. Now at z equals to minus 2. So putting the value of z, I get minus 4 minus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. So minus 4 minus 1 will give me minus 5 divided by minus 2 plus 1 give me minus 1, that gives me 5. So b is equal to 5. So my a is equal to minus 3 I received, and b is equal to 5, what we have been calculated. So now I will resubstitute the values. I get h of z by z as equal to minus 3 upon z plus 1 plus 5 upon z plus 2. Okay. Now taking this z again, the numerator, I get h of z equals to minus 3z upon z plus 1 plus 5z upon z plus 2. Now, I will pull out z common from the denominator. So, I get minus 3z and I write like this, z into, now this is 1 plus I will have 1 by z, that 1 by z I can write it as z inverse. Plus, I do the same thing on the other term and I get z common, it will be 1 plus 2 by z, that will give me 2z inverse. So, z gets cancelled. You get minus 3 upon 1 plus z inverse plus 5 upon 1 plus 2z raised to minus 1. Okay. Now, my h of z is minus 3 by 1 plus z inverse and plus 5 upon 1 plus 2z inverse. Now, step 4 is step 3b. Step 3b, that is a sub step of step 3, is to apply inverse z transform. So now I will be applying inverse z transform to obtain h of n from h of z. So the constant terms will come out. 1 upon 1 plus z is u of n. So I will emphasize it like this. 1 upon 1 plus z inverse is nothing but minus 1 raised to n u of n, and 1 upon 1 plus 2z inverse is minus 2 raised to n u of n. Okay, so whenever we have a form of 1 upon 1 plus z inverse, that time here is 1. So, I'll write minus 1 raised to n u of n, and whenever I have a form 1 upon 1 plus 2z inverse, that time it will give minus 2 raised to n u of n. You see it is plus 2, so I'm putting minus 2. It is plus 1, so I'm putting minus 1. Okay, so sign should be reversed. So, minus 3 of constant comes out and I will write 1 upon 1 plus z inverse as minus 1 raised to n u of n. Then I will write plus and removing the scaling of 5, and 1 upon 1 plus 2 can be written as minus 2 raised to n u of n. Finally, I can write h of n as equals to minus 3 into minus 1 raised to n plus 5 into minus 2 raised to n. The whole is taken common u of n. Adjusting the negative part will give 5 minus 2 raised to n minus 3 minus 1 raised to n, the whole multiplied by u of n. This is my h of n. This is the required solution. Thank you.